As evening falls on day three here in Gwangju, they're a beautiful shot of this Korean city hosting the 28th Summer University Games. In tonight's highlights, we'll head out to rowing. And we'll go inside to check out diving, the women's 10-meter platform synchronized and the men's 1-meter springboard. Shooting also takes center stage, the women's 25-meter pistol being one of the events. We have 4 medals in judo, as well as multiple medals in swimming to be contested here tonight. We also have fencing action, the men's foil individual gold medal bout and the women's saber individual. We go now about 200 kilometers outside of Gwangju to the Chungju Tangyeom Lake, the site of rowing here at Universiad. We will take a look at the men's coxless fours. There's the start list. We are midway through the race here. You can see the Germans closest to you. And they will pull away just at the end, ahead of the Netherlands. And Italy will come in third. The team of Jacob Schneider, Tobias Oppermann, Arnie Schweidel, and Clemens Ernsting claim gold for Germany. There you see in a time of 5 minutes, 58.29 seconds. And there are the medalists. Moving on to the women's lightweight double sculls. Start list there. And in lane three, it is Japan just outside of your screen. Lane two, that is Poland trying to keep up with the Japanese. Oishi and Tomita for Japan maintaining a healthy distance away from Kowalska and Mikolajczak of Poland. There you get a close-up of the Japanese. And as we near the finish line, Japan with just enough to move into a first place finish. A gold for Japan, silver for Poland, bronze for Italy. And there you see Ayami Oishi and Chiaki Tomita, the gold medalists here in the women's lightweight double sculls. And finally, the men's lightweight coxless fours. There you see in lane three, that's the Japanese team. And the German crew right there in your view. Japan with a 67/100th of a second lead on Germany right now. And they've stretched it to a full boat length lead. And they maintain that right to the finish line. Japan in first, Germany second, and Italy in third. The crew of Shota Araki, Tsugo Hayashi, Takumi Shiga, and Kakuro Sato claim Japan's second gold medal here in rowing. And there are the final results. And the medalists in the men's lightweight coxless fours. There you get an aerial look at the Nambu University Aquatic Center here in Gwangju. We have women's synchronized 10-meter platform diving. There you see the dive order. We will start with Wang and Wang of China. Wang Han won a silver in the 10-meter platform yesterday, while Wang Ying won the gold. So these two are definitely favorites heading into this synchronized competition.
Correction, 6.5, 6.5.
A look at that dive there. Bit short on the entry. They will score 69.30. Now move to the Koreans. Ko Yoon Ji and Moon Na Yoon. A really nice dive for that duo. Get a really good close-up view of it there. Good synchronization. Maybe slight over-rotation on the entry, but a score of 66.36 puts them in second spot. Now to the Canadians, Caroline Ware and Selena Toth. Ware was sixth back on July 5th on the tower.
Execution.
You get another angle on this dive, a bit off in terms of synchronization, as you can see. But they will score 71.04, and that will help them win the gold medal with a total score of 297.30. Korea takes silver, China the bronze. We move on now to the men's 1 meter springboard final. And there the dive order for this competition. First up, we'll take a look at Branham Herrera of the United States. This is his first dive. He competes back home for the University of Miami. Good slow motion view of that dive for him. Bit of splash on the entry. He'll score 67.20. Next up with an inward 2.5 somersault. This is Zhang Jinghao. Look at the power off the board. And a good clean entry, a score of 81.60. That temporarily puts him in first place. Now his fourth dive, this is Peng Jianfeng. He won the gold already in the 3 meter springboard held here in Guangzhou on Saturday. And a beautiful dive there, clean entry. Here's the aerial view of it. There you see that clean entry for Peng. He'll score 81.60, and that will propel him to his second gold medal of Universiade. Zhang will take silver, while Herrera claims bronze. Shooting action continues here in Guangzhou from the Nanju Jeollanam-do shooting range. We'll get going first with the women's 25-meter pistol competition. And in the final, it features Kim Ji-hae and Zhu King-yuan. There you see the Korean, Ji-hae. She qualified second out of the semifinal with a score of 17. And for Zhu, she qualified first in that same semifinal with a score of 19. There you get a close-up of the targets for Kim. And there for Zhu. And as Kim finishes up, she claims the gold medal with a score of 7, beating Zhu, who ended up with 5. Lin Yumei of China will take the bronze medal. Now we go outside to the men's trap, the gold medal match. This features Valerio Grazzini of Italy and Filip Marinov of Slovakia. Marinov was 12th at Junior Worlds back in 2013 and won a bronze earlier in the day in the men's trap team competition. For Grazzini, he won a silver earlier as well with Italy in that same men's team trap competition. And he will complete the back-to-back double-double as he won 2 medals at Kazan in Universiade, a silver in both the individual and team trap competition. Now it's just a matter here of which color his medal will be. There you see Marinov. And Grazzini will add a gold medal now to his total as he hits 14 out of 15 targets to win gold. İlnam Yavuz of Turkey will take the bronze. There's the start list for the men's 50-meter pistol. Park Dae-hoon of Korea, there you see him. He won gold in the 50-meter pistol team competition earlier in the day. And was also second at a World Cup event in Changwon earlier this year.
At the moment, moment, Zhang is on the 8th place and now 1.1 behind the
Also in this competition, Rinat Ayupov of Russia. He claimed silver today in the team competition.
And ladies and gentlemen, heading to the second place.
We get another close-up of Park. And now Ayupov. And with that final one, Park wins gold for Korea. Rinat Ayupov, silver. Wang Zhiwei of China will take home a bronze medal. Four judo medals up for grabs here tonight in Gwangju, the Yeomju Bitgyul Gymnasium. The site will start with the women's under 52 kilogram class. Mako Uchio of Japan taking on Alexandra Florian of Romania. Florian in white, Uchio in blue. Uchio won bronze at last year's World Junior Championships while Florian won silver. But here it will be Uchio with the Ippon to win the gold medal. You'll get a good look at it right here as she gets Florian fully on her back to score the Ippon. Levitska of Ukraine and Chop of Switzerland take the bronze medals. Moving on now to the men's under 66 kilograms class. An Bayul of Korea taking on Alexandre Mariac of France. Mariac in white, An in blue. And there you have an Ippon scored for the Korean. And on home soil, he will win the gold medal, defeating Mariac of France. And there you'll get a good look at it. Just there, getting the Frenchman to his back to score the Ippon. The bronze medals in this category will go to Piras of Italy and Ardanov of Russia. Back to the women, the under 57 kilogram class. Sumaya Dordsarin of Mongolia up against Andrea Bekic of Croatia. Dordsarin in white, Bekic in blue. The Mongolian has won 3 gold medals in Grand Prix or Masters events so far this year. You can see her working on Bekic. And for long enough that she scores an Ippon to defeat the Croatian and win gold. Doesn't score it initially there, but the time held on her back. That'll give the gold medal to Dorsarin. Bronze medals to Kim of Korea and Yamamoto of Japan. And the final bout of the night, the men's under 73 kilogram class. Dimitro Kavanets of Ukraine up against An Changrim of Korea. Kavanets in blue, An in white. An won the gold at the Asian Championship in Kuwait earlier this year, and with that Ippon, early in this bout, he will win the gold medal here. Good look at it there, as the Ukrainian ends up on his back, giving on the goal. Yamamoto of Japan takes bronze, as does Raimili of Azerbaijan. Back to the pool for swimming competition, the Nambu University Aquatic Center, the site of swimming at Universiad. We'll take a look at the women's 1500 meter final. This features a bronze medalist from the Universiad in Kazan in 2013. That will be Martina Caramignoli of Italy. This is, of course, one of the most grueling races in swimming. And there you see Caramignoli looking to better her bronze from 2013. And as she powers her way along here, she has a clear lead over Lindsey Vrooman of the United States. Vrooman was third at last year's U.S. Nationals, but it won't be enough. Cara Mignoli, a gold medal in a time of 16 minutes and 6 seconds. Vrooman from the United States will take silver, and Kia Melverton of Australia will win the bronze medal. And there you see the results in the women's 1500 meters and our three medalists. The women's 100 meter breaststroke comes up next. This features Fiona Doyle in lane 6. She won a silver in this event at Kazan in 2013. Get a good overhead view of these swimmers. As they make their way to the final touch, it is very close. Mina Matsushima of Japan battling with Lilia King of the United States and Fiona Doyle. Very close here, up to the wall, but it's going to be Matsushima just ahead of King. And Doyle, who actually swims in Canada for the University of Calgary, she will take the bronze medal. There you have the full results from the women's 100 meter breaststroke. And the three medalists, Matsushima, King, and Doyle. The men back in the pool, the 200 meter freestyle. Features two Americans who placed well at last year's U.S. Nationals. Reed Malone in lane 4 was fourth, and Clay Youngquist in lane 7, he was fifth in the United States at their national championships in 2014. Malone here with a healthy lead as he makes his way to the wall. It is a battle for second and third. Malone touches first, and then Youngquist just ahead of Jacob Hansford of Australia. So in a time of 1 minute 47.15 seconds, Reed Malone will win gold for the United States. Clay Youngquist second, and Jacob Hansford third. We now move on to the men's 200 meter individual medley. And in lane 5, the defending Universiade gold medalist from Kazan in 2013, that will be Justin James of Australia. He is battling here with Josh Pronneau of the United States. Pronneau right next to him in lane 4. And they are neck and neck right up to the wall. And it appears as though Pronneau touches first. But upon further review, it's a dead heat, a tie. Both James and Pronneau will win gold medals in a time of 1 minute 58.38 seconds. Keita Tsunami of Japan will win the bronze medal. A bit of an overcast day here in Guangzhou as you look outside the Kim Dae-jung Convention Center here in Guangzhou. We'll move inside for the men's individual foil competition, the gold medal bout. This features Maximilien Chastanet of France taking on Alexander Pivovarov of Russia. Pivovarov there on the left, Chastanet on the right. Chastanet has two top five junior World Cup finishes so far this year. He defeated Martino Menuto 15-8 in the semifinal to get to this bout. For Pivovarov, he won a gold medal as part of Team Sabre at 2014's under-23 European Championships. And he beat Kwok Joon-hyuk 15-14 in the semifinal to get here. There's a nice attack from the Frenchman. And another battle, point one there by Chastanet. 10-8 now, Chastanet leading. There's a simultaneous touch, but it goes in favor of Pivovarov. And there's a nice riposte from Chastanet. He's got a 12-9 lead. Make it now 13-9. Kvovarov cannot score there. Chastanet does. He's 1 point away from the gold medal. And there it is. Maximilien Chastanet of France wins 15-10 to take the gold medal. Alexander Pivovarov wins silver. Minuto of Turkey wins bronze, as does Kwok of Korea. On now to the women's individual saber final. This features Anna Bashta of Russia and Kim Seon-hee of Korea. Bashta was part of the gold medal saber team at the 2014 World Junior Championships. She knocked off Adrian Jaraki of the United States 15-11 in her semifinal to get here. For Kim, she beat Marta Puda of Poland to earn a berth in the final. Good crowd on hand. 8-6 right now. Make it now 8-7 as Bashta scores. Some instructions there from the Korean coach for Kim, and the same for Bashta. Nice attack there from Kim to score. Then an injury to the right arm of Bashta. She requires medical attention. Gets that right hand frozen a little bit. See how that affects her. Trailing right now 10-9, now 11-9. Good attack, but the counter from Bashta to score. And her coach likes that. 12-11, Kim in the lead, but it's now tied up as Bashta scores. Now at 13 all. And Bashta again to take a 14-13 lead. But Kim won't go away, knots it up at 14. Next point wins the gold. And it will be Bashta, exuberant, winning the gold medal for Russia. Kim wins silver. Adrian Jaraki of the United States wins bronze, as does Marta Puda of Poland.